Let's sort you out. Safe, bruiser boy. Always a pleasure. Now fuck right along.
Did you see something out there? That tower!
I see no tower.
Maybe I'm seeing things. So Odin robbed Freya of her warrior spirit?
Aye. Freya can't fight, even to defend herself!
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Ha!
So Odin robbed Freya of a warrior spirit?
Aye. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Good fight. me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the God Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue hanging over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. We were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor... My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue.
Spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Namir. Why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the Giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the Giant Kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, and victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Or I can just tell you this story later.
Ethric!
Brock. We found something.
Let me guess. Something I can build with? How'd I know?
Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
I'd heard rumors of a powerful dwarf ruling over some poor sods not far from here. Not that you asked me.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. Well, here it is. It's gotta have a weak point. Somewhere.
Fall this easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
No.
His father's grave. Find anything good?
Perhaps.
father? Why do the gods cause so much trouble for mortals?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Well, at least we're doing some good, right? That sounds like a dragon. Maybe I can fly.
No, no! Gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
Look, don't be mad, but I've seen those blades of yours before. They were under the house when I was hiding. Is that why you never let me down there? Where did they come from?
They are my burden, from a life that is behind me.
Well, they're in my life too now, and I'd like to hear that story.
Those days are dead. To relive them is needless.
How can it be needless if it's the truth?
One day, you will understand.
I'll take your word for it.
The statue stands no longer, Spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed, and I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave guy. Went to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
Where did the spirit leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No, but perhaps the dwarves can.
So what do you think, Mimir? What does Baldur want with us?
Well, let's look at what we know. Baldur is Odin's finest tracker, bar none. If he wants you, you have to consider the possibility that Odin wants you. And as for what Odin wants, on this I have some expertise.
What could we have that Odin doesn't? He's like the king of gods.
Of the Aesir, aye. But his reach is not unlimited. And where he cannot reach, he is preoccupied with going. He certainly tortured me enough about it over the years.
Hey, Brock, we found something. Let me guess. Something I can build with? How'd I know? Moving on, then.